Hi, folks. Welcome. What a great-looking crowd, especially up over here. What a good-looking bunch over here. We are so glad to have you here for night number three of National Finals tonight. Are you enjoying the rodeo action so far here in Las Vegas? A great night. We're honored to have you here. I'll tell you, this is the quietest place to be right here. It's chaos back there, but you're here for a good night. We've got prizes to give away, including this guitar back here signed by George Strait, so it's going to be a good night. Let's get started. Bring out our co-hosts here. A couple of them, both of them are eight-time world champions. You know them both very well, and I'm honored to share the stage with them every single night. Our eighth year of national finals tonight. The first guy, best bull rider ever, eight-time world champion Donnie Gay is here. Yes.
All right. Yeah, then you get right on Saturday night.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh, a Saturday night.
You've heard that before, hadn't you?
Yes, Saturday night in Las Vegas with Donnie Gay. Doesn't get any better than that, does it, huh?
Well, I don't know. I always had a good time. I don't know about y'all.
I think it's going to be great. Let's bring our buddy out here with us, and we've got a lot of people back there and a lot of things to do. This gentleman, also an eight-time world champion. You know him very well. They don't make better guys than this. Joe Beaver is in the house. Joe, come on out here.
The Big Gay.
You know, the problem with this is most of the time, if he has a good time, everybody else around him catches hell. Because he's not as big as that mouth goes most of the time.
There's a word for instigator.
There you go.
Instigator.
You brought it up,
yes,
not me.
Yes, exactly right. We're so glad to have you. Great crowd here. Let's tell people, if you want to participate in the show and send up a question, there's an easy way to do that. And let me give you a phone number. You can text us a question. We've had a lot of them come in already. The phone number is 702-582-5638. If you're really techie, it's 702-LUCK-NFT. Sounds like one of your texts right there. 702-582-5638. 38 if you would like to send us a question. We do want to tell you, if you want to watch the shows, they are all logged on YouTube. Go to YouTube and National Finals Tonight, or you can find a highlight of our show each and every day on the Wrangler Network, wranglernetwork.com. We've got one question already. Let's quickly do this one, Donnie. This is an easy one. They say, why didn't Boyd announce tonight?
That must have been why he looked so funny at me when I said, great job.
Are you kidding?
No, I'm not. That's a true story.
Oh, my. They bring rotate. Three announcers to the National Finals Rodeo.
Mr. I mean, Johnny on the spot right there, boy.
And they rotate.
Will he be here later?
Okay, so the answer to that question is, how the hell do I know?
Yeah. That'll pretty much wrap up the questions for the evening, so.
Let him text that to you. You damn sure won't know what he says.
Oh, my word. They rotate. Another question that came in, Joe, I want to, because the barrel racing was good tonight. The times were good. Did they do anything with the ground?
That
was what
the question. They had to do something with the ground because it's been terrible the first two nights. And I mean, I lost my job in 99 talking about the ground. So I was trying to be diplomatic about it last night, which I'm not very good at. But I tried to do it. I really tried. And tonight it looked to me like it's a lot better. It's not maybe completely fixed, but it is sure a lot better than it was.
It's going to return to
it'll
what
get
we're
back. And they're working
normal.
At it. I mean, it's not like they don't. But, you know, you go to, you know, high school rodeo, run 800 runs. You go to fraternities, run 2,000 runs, whatever. They can get the ground and make it work. So they got on it last night. They did work it today quite a bit. I think tomorrow, the more water they get on it, the little bit they rip it, it's going to be better and better.
Very good. And guys in audio, if we can get a little more of Joe in our monitor up here, that would be good. Let me brag on Joe for just a second here, because they're talking about people that have earned $1 million just at the National Finals Rodeo. And I was looking at this because Sherry Servey is the one person who has earned a check in 12 rounds straight coming into tonight. But there's an elite group of six people that have earned $1 million just at the National Finals Rodeo, and this gentleman is one of them right here. The other guys, it's not hard to figure it out, Trevor, Cody Ohl, Billy Ettbauer, Sherry Servey, and Fred Whitfield, and Joe is the other one that's made $1 million just at the National Finals Rodeo. And there's a couple of guys that are going to come close this week. They may get
Might get there this week.
Yeah,
they should.
Bobby Moat, Rich Skelton, and Luke Branquino.
Well, Rich is going to have to get to throw his rope first.
Oh, my gosh.
You know, I always say the header's the quarterback. They done benched Nick Sartain. I mean, he's a gold buckle world champion header, and two times out of three, he didn't even hit the target. Yep. You know what I mean? It's over the head of the intended receiver 5 feet tonight.
Was he watching me bowl today?
He might have snuck in one of those jackpots you were at and got that head loop down.
Speaking of which,
he won the bet.
Did you beat LeFue bowl? They're going to be
no,
here.
No, you can tell because he won't answer. He didn't win. You can tell right there. I know who won. LeFue won now.
No, actually, I said no moss.
You just forfeited.
Well, they told me the rules after I got about 8 frames into the thing. You know, it rolling a little ball down there and all that. I spend all my time playing golf trying to break 80. And
not golf,
what did I
and
tell
bowling.
You? He got beat because he won't answer still.
You
see?
Hear that? No
says
moss.
He give up. The not same his. Man that says he give up, that you could have him down in a fight, stomping on him, and he wouldn't get up. You didn't quit. You got beat.
Badly.
There you go. See? Uh-huh. Yeah.
If you didn't get a chance to watch the rodeo on television tonight, Donnie and Joe are doing it live, but they're going to do it live for you here. We put together a highlight package. So let's start with the bareback riding, and Donnie... Take her away, would you?
Okay, I got to brag on Frontier Rodeo's bucking horses. This is Delta Ship. This is one of many we have, Justin McDaniel. This is bareback riding, and about as good as you get. The judges don't know how the points got on their pencils. He was only 89 points. He could have broke 90 really easy. This bucking horse got power. He jumps and kicks. He's straight down the horse's back. You cannot ride a bareback horse any better than that for 89 points, Justin McDaniel.
One more time. Frontier Airlines horse. Steer Wrestling right here, the rookie, Kyle Irwin. He steps in here and splits a go-around last night. Now tonight, he's 3-2. People Arena Records 3-flat. But watch the difference right here. This kid's not that big. His left knee goes all the way to the ground. When it comes up, he's got power. It's over. Watch when he catches a steer. He goes real low with him, but he slides. But he's got a lot of weight on his left side. 3-2 victory lap tonight by himself. First time at the NFR. Team roping, horse change. When you're not winning, change something. Change underwear, socks, horses, women, something. Make yourself win. And right here, this guy, Dustin Bird, traded horses 3-net winning around tonight.
He did a great job. The saddle bronc riding, Wade Sundell. Got bucked off last night, looking for revenge. How about the Iowa guy? Watch him pick this bucking horse up. Belongs to my daddy, Neil Gay. This horse jumping and kicking, just a nice horse.
One more time, whose horse?
Neil Gay's bucking horse, yes, sir. I'm telling you, watch him set his feet, lift on the rein. This is not the best horse in this pen. They were all Tweedley D's, but he made the best bronc ride I've seen all week.
Another horse change. Cody Ohl, last night, breaks a rope, gets on another horse tonight. You know, this guy, he's just ridiculous. I mean, he's 6'6 right here. Arena record, 6'5. This is the first time he's rode this horse in a big crowd like that. And I'll be honest, he was throwing, pulling, and a wrap mahui. He might win 5 or 6 more go-rounds this week because he has no average, he has no conscience, and he has no care about winning second place. Cody Ohl, 6'6".
Nice hat throw as well. Look at that baby.
Well, he's had a lot of practice. That's 50 go-arounds.
Yes.
50 in the tie-down rope, and count them. That's a lot. Cassidy Dennison, this horse, I watched him at the INFR last year. She won it over there at South Point. This year, this horse is one of the few that hadn't had any trouble right there. At the second barrel, he didn't bother us tonight. He went on in there and dropped and turned. A lot of horses I thought were playing shadow box of the second barrel. Cassidy gets her a day money victory.
All right, the world number one, Sage Kimsey, in the bull riding tonight. Last night, he won third place. Got the lineman round to the left away from his hand. Technically, this is a perfect bull ride from Sage Kinsey. He'd ridden the bull before. Watch the body position. Watch his free hand, elbow. Everything is totally perfect. Toes turned out. This kid was 84 and a half. Nice job right there. Bull riders didn't ride as good as they should have tonight, but we got one of them coming here that did. But Sage Kinsey made a nice ride, made a statement for himself, and I'm going to bet you $5 that he wins a go-round tomorrow night.
And a $5 bet to win the world looks pretty good.
Oh, yeah.
Really good.
Good job, you guys. Give him a hand. Nice job on the highlight reel for you there. It's a good night already, isn't it? Let's get some folks out here and talk with them. We've got a lot of people backstage ready to come out and visit with you. I'm so glad this gentleman is with us. We've tried the last couple of years. He's got young kids at home, and he has not been able to come back out and join us, but he is here tonight, and I'm glad. Three-time world champion in the bareback riding, Will Lowe is here tonight. Would you give him a hand? Will.
Willie Lowe.
Guys.
Thank you, buddy.
Have a seat, Willie.
Thank you.
All right.
It's so good to have you here, Will Lowe, three-time world champion. We haven't seen you here with us for the last couple of years, and I'm glad you had time. Thanks for coming out to be with us.
Well, you know, like I said, thanks for having us back. We got lots of obligations, you know, obviously, everywhere around, and I like coming and bullshitting with y'all, though.
That's
Hey, one thing about it over here, they don't tell you what to say or how to say it.
Joe? Well,
I'm a living example.
Yeah, I've heard a few of them. They cast them or wherever.
How many NFRs do you go to?
22.
I went to 13 in the bull riding. He's gone to 13 in the bareback riding.
And I'm sorry, that's the roughest
that's
event
the toughest
in rodeo.
Event physically that there is on the planet.
And if you don't believe it, watch Tim O'Connell last night.
He's not nearly done, but the other thing I want to tell y'all is his wife's here, and this is their 12th anniversary right here. Yeah,
that's a tough woman right there, boy. Yes. That Tiff is tough to put up with this for 12 years.
Good to have her with us here this evening. And two young ones at home now. You've got
5 and 2.
5 and 2 years of age. And this gentleman on Christmas Eve is going to be turning 32, and when we're talking about it, this is a good year for you. I think you won first in 13 rodeos and either won them or co-champion on that. And so physically, Donnie alluded to it, how are you feeling, Will?
Great. You know, you get sore. That's obvious. You know, you ride bucking horses. But having fun. I love to do it. And I feel good. You know,
family travels with you on the road?
We're lucky. You know, our in-laws are from Colorado. And Tiffany's from Colorado, and so in the summer she goes up there and rodeos, and you know, goes to stuff around there, Cheyenne, Sheridan this year, a bunch of them, and so they're on the road. They usually go to Calgary with me, and then you know, it just kind of depends on the schedule. You know, it changes so fast every year.
Rodeo, you're centrally located whenever you're in
Tiffany
Texas
finally
till March.
Tiffany finally learned to play it by ear.
Life
you know,
is much
that's how we roll,
that.
Play by ear. Sorry, Donnie. But, you know how it goes. You don't know when you're entered at some of them rodeos till 2 weeks before.
The only thing I hate worse than losing is a plan, because the plans just usually don't come together.
Exactly.
The man is still riding as good as ever, and let's take a look at you in action. Let's start off. You can see it right there in front of you, Will. Let's do from tonight, first of all. Let's take a look at the ride tonight, and then we'll pick up on first night. But this is tonight. Talk about what you see.
Oh, Cool Water. I've been on that horse a lot of times, and right there I set that foot on top of her neck, and you know, you kick over on one of them, you got to get it down, you got to kick it out and get it down, and it hit the cinch. You know, I had to for the most part. Once you kick it out, you just got to aim lower, and you tuck your chin so hard that you know, you still have your hips, but
you push it back down.
You get it back down there low, and then that right foot hit the deal, and she's coming into it, so it kind of makes it want to be tighter anyways. That horse throws your feet so hard, though, and bucks. I've never had her get that tight circle like that. I've had her 4 times here at the NFR, and she's always gone straight down there and faded at the end, and she's rank. You usually don't make the pickup man on that horse.
This pin.
But I love that horse.
This pin typically is this will be the TV pin for Saturday, for next Saturday night. in the finale, you think, most of these horses that we saw tonight?
No. 2 years ago, we kind of decided to split our TV pen up because we had such great horses coming along with Frontiers Pen, Assault, a bunch of these great horses that in our TV pen, we'd have a Fancy Free, a Scott of Classic Pro Rodeos, and then we'd have Delta Ship and Full Baggage, because you could be 90 on both of all those horses, but it was a lot easier to ride one of those horses than it was to ride the other one. So what we did is we decided to split our TV pen up into, we pretty much have two TV pens now. We took a lot of these horses, you look back through the years, they've all been in the TV pen. They just, a lot of them get a little older and learn a few more tricks. They're a little stronger to ride, harder to ride, and so we just move them into that TV pen, or into that Eliminator pen, where, you still be 90, obviously.
I tell you, that was a really, really rank set of bucking horses tonight in the bareback riding. I mean, the difference between them, of course, they're coming out at different times and to compare to the Saddle Bronx, but that was a nice pen of Bronx tonight, and they all knew it. But the difference between the two was just kind of shocking.
Let's take a look at round one. This was on Bartender, and I think it was 83 points. First night on Thursday night. Will, if you can take a look at
I've never seen this horse before. She was on a picture of the sports news, though, with a younger guy from South Dakota, I believe, Troy Vira. Anyways, an awesome picture on the front, and when Ratliff said he used a bunch of points on her, she's really fun. She was nice. Those are our really good ones.
You imagine getting on 10 of those 13 different times and taking the pounding that you're taking? Is the fire in your belly still as strong as it was when you were trying to win your first world title?
I just try to ride each horse how it is. I don't really worry about the standings and the points. And it's been that way from the beginning. And I hate to say it, but I never really watched rodeo on TV, never followed any of the standings growing up and stuff. I nod my head to win every time. I do it because I love it, and the standings and the rest of it, that's,
After you ride good, it takes care of itself.
I know what it was, so I ain't worried about it.
But the interesting thing to me now, Will, you and Bobby Moat are the veterans. You're the veterans, and you've got all these young kids, and some of these young kids, and I've been following, some of these young kids can ride, and it's, do you feel like the veteran out there with a bunch of kids?
Yeah, a little bit, but...
You're trying to say he's grown up?
Yeah. No. But...
Make her choke on her beer over there. Let her enjoy her beer.
The thing is, there's not a whole lot of bareback riders, in the numbers, but the ones that are there, they're there because they're badass. They got the mindset that, to take the punishment for the most part.
Yeah, because it's not like you could be a half-ass team roper and get pie. If you're a half-ass bareback rider, they jerk your arm off your body and crush everything else and send you home. You got to be good at bareback riding or you don't succeed at all.
And you see, one little mistake, especially on these horses, will put you down so hard, you got to tuck and roll.
Will is also a... Will is also a good young man, too, because he's trying to help someone else. And when we talked about Will coming out, he said, there's a fellow that wants to be in music, wants to be a country singer. And he said, I'm just going to have him come to Las Vegas and see what we can do. And so I told Will to bring him by. And if you'll introduce him to bring him up here with me, I'll talk to him just a second, Will, and we'll find out about him. And he's going to be up at the Buck and Ball a little bit later on. But you introduce who he is.
Well, I appreciate you letting Troy come up here with me. I know it's a tough industry, but I know Troy's grandparents really well and watched him play quite a few times. His father had a band, and so from the time he could walk, he was on, playing the guitar with his dad and on stage and stuff like that. And I've watched him play quite a few times, local deals around the sure. Vail area, Eagle, Colorado area, and... Troy Harris, he's a
Troy,
great
come
kid.
On up come here, on would up you here, please? Troy. I'm just going to stand up here. Sings out. Give this young
welcome,
man a hand, would you hear? Come on over here, Troy, and say hi to Donnie Gay there and talk to just come talk to me here a little bit up here. Troy, I've actually looked at your videos on YouTube, and yes, and you're a good singer and doing
very well.
Just tell us briefly about the band. We've got a picture. We're going to take a picture of your band over here and tell us who's with you and how's it going.
Well, I'm Troy Harris, and I'm lead guitar player and lead vocals, and we got Brandon Lee Gardner. He's from Crosby, Texas, and he's rhythm guitar and lead vocals as well. And then we got Zach Rozelle. I don't know what part of Texas he's from. He's from Springs, Texas, and he's our drummer. Then he's actually my cousin Marvin. He's our bass player, and we're just trying to be like any other country singer.
Yep, and yeah, I tell you what, YouTube is a huge part of it. And so if you get the chance to go on and see this gentleman on YouTube, do that. But also, and coming up later on this evening, we hope you all go up to the Buck and Ball. He's going to be up there and sing a couple of songs. Gary LaFue is going to work that out. And spending most of my life in Nashville, I'm pulling for you. So we wish you the very best.
Well,
we thank you for coming
it.
Up with here.
That.
And we hope that you'll
all
see
right.
him upstairs
thank
later
you,
on.
Troy.
My pleasure. My pleasure. And playoff. Will Lowe back here. Will you give him a hand, Will Lowe? Thank you, sir.
You talk about a tough little scamp.
That's a long time to ride bareback horses, and he's not done.
I have to do some research. No, he's not anywhere close to done.
No.
No.
You know, and he rides so good. The good news is some of the big money rodeos, he doesn't have to go to 100 rodeos to be able to get here. He rides that good.
That's right, Donnie. As a matter of fact, I talked with him earlier about that he took his time and got started. But then again, he goes to Albuquerque and he wins $5,000 there, picking and choosing and doing the right thing. So let's move along here from a veteran to a young man. Joe Beaver, and this guy has been exciting to watch already. Let's get him out here and talk to him a little bit. I think the next big deal in the tie down roping.
Boy Wonder.
Boy Wonder.
Boy Wonder.
Marty Yates,
Marty Yates,
good looking kid too. Bring him
out
here.
Come on out here. Yeah, boy.
Well,
I just been wanting to see him go head to head with Joe Beaver.
You're not going to see it? He's not going to build his reputation on me. But last year, we did have a little tying session. Just because he was
Please
French fried. He was toasted. He hated his horse. He hated roping. He hated Well, he was at the right place because I'd done all that, you know. I hated everything. So he come down last year. We put him together, sent him off first rodeos of the year, and he wins checks at 8 out of 10. In the first 2 weeks. And I told his mom then, I said, get ready, because he's a real deal. And look where he's at now.
It's been, yes, give him a hand.
Yeah,
it's exciting to watch you. Yeah. For us, Marty, I got to tell you, it's exciting to watch you, not only the way you performed the first night, and we'll take a look at that in a minute, but the confidence in you. So let's go back to the deal, the schooling here. Did you go to Joe or did he call you? How did that work? Tell us, Marty.
Well, actually, I went to Joe because I needed to sell my horse.
I wasn't going to bring it up, but he said, the horse was terrible, and this is a runner-up to the horse of the year this year. This is the one he's riding right now. And you know, I made a promise to him a long time ago, I'd take care of him. If he ever needed help, take care of him, you know, we'll take care of him. All the Yateses of Hampton's been friends for years. So he shows up, and I ride the horse the first day, and I thought, God, yeah, I did say I'd take care of him, but, you know, there's limits to everything. He says, his mom called me, he hates that horse, you got to sell him. So I said, well, Marty, what do you think his horse is worth? I mean, if I get $25,000, I'd be, and it just hit me, you know, because I'm thinking I can get $75,000 in a week for him. So I ride him the first day, and he gets pretty good. And the second day, he gets real good. And the third day, I said, little Marty, before I have a minute to change my mind, get on this horse and rope, and I'm going to honor what I said. I'm going to take care of you because the other part of Joe wants to screw you out of this horse for $25,000 and sell him for $75,000 next week. So the only time in the world my conscience bothered me, I don't know what the hell it got in the way for, but it did.
I'm
but
so
I sure am glad, because look what it's done now. We have a dynasty in the building right here with that little Sawhorse Chicken and Marty Yates.
And Marty, from your standpoint, when you talked to Joe, how long did it take to click for you?
For me and that horse, and I went to Joe, and he showed me a few things to put on him. And that day, he's been the same horse since the time we put it on. We put that stuff on him. He showed me a few things to put on his head and showed me how to ride him. And from that day, we've been doing the same thing as y'all seen. Well, not the second night, but the first and third night, that's for sure.
And talk about your start here in, go ahead, Donnie, wanted to say something. Let's do this. Let's take a look at the tonight's run, Joe, and you guys can talk about that. We also have his first night, but let's take a look at tonight
first. Well, it's a rebound night, because I talked to him today, and I said, hey, you know, last night's over. Right here, he got a little indecisive where to put his slack, so there he's in a panic mode. And Marty can go so fast and forward that when he gets to this calf, instead of slowing, watch right here, see, ropes him? He goes inside with his slack, but he's a little confused where the calf's going to be, and right here, he just got strung out and dropped the front leg. Now, 7-9 is fast, but if he doesn't drop the leg, it's 7-6. That's me being critical because I know what he can do. Still a good run, still got by one, got your rhythm back, don't you?
Yes, sir. Right there, I felt better than I did. Coming across, I felt real uncomfortable the second night, and tonight, I felt like I got me a good start and was able to get it on her, and just... I didn't know where to go right there. I was a little bit panicked, and then I got in panic mode right here and just missed the front leg trying to hurry.
But here's the deal. When you can make a mistake, be 7-9, you know, then there's stuff to build on. It's not like he was 13-4, you know. I mean, he's made a really good run. The first night I thought was one, it looked just like we left the practice pen Wednesday afternoon, and he stepped into the first round. It was flawless. It was perfect. It was great. And then everybody throws all these big expectations, and, you know, the first NFR is different. Well, now everybody's on Marty's bandwagon, and then he has a little trouble the second time. Well, then you see your boat shift. You know, that's when it goes to back and forth, and everybody panics, you know, oh, what's he going to do now? And I said, y'all, take your seat. Don't move, because it's going to come right back. And tonight he did, 7-9.
How about a tough go-round in the tie-down rope?
I mean,
I mean, four places?
Yeah, wow. Well, and just like, what'd you win, 7-9? Sixth? Yeah, one last hole right there, 7-9. So, I mean, yeah. Is this the first night?
Yes, if we've got that rack back there, Jeremy and Jason, let's take a look at the night that he won, the first night on Thursday.
And you
got
to remember, too, guys, you know, this is a kid the first year out here, too. The first night, good start, really controls his rope good. Now, watch this. Big and strong, and say he steps back with that calf. He brings the calf to him. The only thing I said is when he put a rap movie on him, he almost got me fined on TV. Because I have choice words for choice situations, and it almost came out right there. I was like, and I got done with some Marty. He said, I knew that calf, he felt good. I said, well, do me a favor. Don't feel that good no more unless you have to. You know, Cody Old puts a rap movie on the first round, but Cody Old's a maniac, you know? But it also paid you a day money and a trip to the buckle ceremony. And look, that made the difference right there. When you stuck it on him right here, what'd you feel like first run?
Oh, man, it's everything I wanted it to be. I felt like when I got to her head, I was patient and then really came up and stepped back with her. And, man, I told myself in the back, you're putting two raps on her no matter how good she feels. And when I got up after I put two raps, I said, I took off to my horse, and I was like, no way. No, I did not just put a rat mahouy on that calf. No way.
I got to ask you, what was the feeling whenever you took the victory lap first night?
Man, everything I ever wanted to be. I've ran that calf 1,000,000 times in the living room, roping the dummy. First calf at the first NFR, man, it's pretty special. It's a good feeling to be able to do it on that horse, too, with the relationship we have. So it's pretty cool.
Well, you created a lot of followers and new fans, and I know you even thrilled some old ones. That looked good.
Well, I tell you what's good about this is we always talk about the next generation. You know, Cody Old can't rope forever. You know, Fred Whitfield can't rope forever. Willow can't ride bareback horse forever. You have to have the next regime coming in. And I told Marty this the other day when we were at the house before he left. I said, okay, here's the deal. Go out there and rope good and win, have fun. But I said, well, if you get a chance to talk, you think before you speak and let them know you can do that too, because that's part of winning. the more you won, the more you got to talk, you know. And I thought he did a really good job the other night in the interview. I was real proud of him. When they got him down there for the go-around win, he was precise. He was you know, grateful, but he wasn't, you know, all day in there and thinking people off from the moon and stuff, you know. And that's part of a champion, which he's been since he's been that big. And now it's just stepping to a new era of championship.
You've got a group of people with you here tonight.
Oh, we got a whole section.
Let's put a camera over here. There's lots of folks over there, and I would like for Marty to say, just say who's with you over here. If the camera guys, there we go.
Man, I got my mom with me. She's my rock. Yeah, I got my grandmother, my great grandmother's out here with us. My aunt JJ, 17-time world champion. Rich Newton, he's out here taking care of my horses. Sonny Yates, my grandpa, Roehampton, my uncle, Jeff Yates, my uncle, and little Kaysen, he's over there. So
I'm going to throw something in.
Wow.
I wrote pretty damn good. I do. I wouldn't match J.J. Hampton in a breakaway match if you spotted me 4 or 5 seconds to start. That's where he learned to rope the necks right there. That's the nastiest breakaway roper you've ever seen in your life right there. So it runs in the family.
I'll tell you, there's a huge reason why he's a success as well. It's not just the talent, it's the support. We're honored to have all of you with us here. I know you're proud of him. Too bad he's such a homely young guy, huh? But boy, he's got it all, the whole package, and we're excited for you, Marty, and we wish you the very, very best, and we'll see you in the winner's circle a lot here, I'm sure.
Boy Wonder, that's my boy Marty Yates.
Nice.
Wasn't that worth the trip, Barton?
How good is that, huh? How good is that? Just great. And you know, something else I want to just say quickly. Last night, Trey Benton III was here with us, with Gary Lafue, and they were talking about, Donnie was talking about mental toughness and all. What did Trey Benton III do tonight?
He walked in the locker room tonight, and he just walked by me, and he goes, I'm pumped. He said, things are going to be different tonight.
Oh, man.
They were. He won second.
They made
a good ride. Just did what he's supposed to do.
Speaking of, let me tell you one thing.
You know what I like last night? Trey Benton walked off, and we talked just for like that. And I said, well, you ready? He said, you know what? Now I am. He said, it's a different deal to look in the champion's eyes and know they're telling you what they really believe. And that means something right there, because tonight he come back 1 second. So we're not as full of it as halftime we think we are, but anyway.
Well, you know, speaking of champions, great bull riders, right here. There's one standing over here. Y'all turn the light back on, right back over here against the wall. Come up here, Denny.
This is one of my heroes right here.
Come on Denny out here on stage.
Denny Flynn is in the house.
Denny Flynn, Charleston, Arkansas. There's, I can't brag on him enough, and just one of my best friends. You know, Lynn's over there, we did have some battles.
Well, I mean, we had some good battles. So, yeah. I mean, you know, we had a good time rodeoing. I'm just so proud that these guys are winning so much more money than me and you did. I hope my kid comes in here and wins more money than they ever did.
That's right.
And with the go-arounds paying $28,000 next year or whatever they said is going to, it's just getting better and better and better.
You know, Denny, I'd like for you to just comment. I know you watch the bull riding tonight? Did you see the bull riding tonight? What do you think about overall the 15 guys? You've been to many, many national finals. I'm kind of pumped for them. Because to me, they got the right attitude, and there's a group of 8 rookies that really don't act like rookies to me.
Well, these guys, you know, the boys that's coming in now, there's some kids in there that can really ride. And, you know, I had a question asked to me the other day, who do you think the greatest bull rider was? And the only answer I could say was, maybe the greatest bull rider's never even been born. Maybe one of these kids are going to come up there and beat all of our records. You know, records are meant to be broken. And We got some kids here that really ride good. I think thought Trey Benton rode really good. I thought Sage rode really good. I mean, that kid has been riding good all year. Yep. And you got some guys that's going up there. I really thought you know, those bulls are really good tonight. Just a good set of bulls, and I think those guys really showed what they can do.
We're going to bring out a first-time NFR bull rider right now, he's a rookie, but he's not a rookie. What do you think about Joe Frost?
Well, I've known Joe Frost for a while now. Joe's come to my house, and we've talked quite a bit about riding bulls, and I've shared with him what it takes to come to the NFR, and I think Joe Frost is a cool bull riding kid. I think Joe Frost has got the belly. I really, honestly, I thought he should have won a round tonight, but that's just my opinion.
Oh, I'm going to get us started on that.
It's okay to be partial.
Yeah.
Come on out here,
Joe Frost. Come on out here.
Joe Frost.
Books too hard.
Hey, he not only rides bulls.
How about a round of applause for Denny Flynn?
Donnie, this guy doesn't only ride bulls good. He steer wrestles and ropes calves.
That's right.
Quite handily, I might add.
That's right.
Stand up.
He's kind of sawed off, ain't he?
Heck, I thought we were just alike.
Now, let me go ahead and tell you, y'all ain't nothing alike, okay?
Joe, we're so glad to have you here. And matter of fact, just before you came out, I was looking. You won several all-around titles this year, which is what Joe is alluding to. You're a full all-around cowboy. And how did you decide what between the three events? Has it always been bull riding? Has that been your love?
This is the only one I have any luck at most of the time.
This is the only guy that's covered all three bulls.
Okay,
so far,
I got a question. I know you're 3 for 3. I know you don't act like a rookie. But you only got one more semester in college before you graduate with a degree in ag business. What in the hell are you doing riding bulls?
I don't know what I'm going to do with the ag business
degree. That's what I was going to say. You know, I'm thinking another way. I'm thinking, throw that degree away. Let's go. It pays more out of here.
You know what he told me? I asked him, have you finished college yet? And he goes, no, but I'm about to. I got one more semester. And I said, before I could ask the question what he was gonna be, he said, man, I am going to be able to go to some rodeos now.
That's right. Dan, let me tell you, he was hurt this year. He was hurt for, what, two weeks. He's down. So I got this school at Goodwill, Oklahoma. And him and his brother always come tie and rope with us, hang out. So I get there the first day, and he's kind of packing it. I was, what's the matter with you? He said, I'm hurt. I can't rope or tie any. I said, good, you can run the chute. So for 3 days.
Yeah, and then you hollered at me every time I did anything.
Then, wait, he was running the chute. Well, look here, what he do? He just reached up to that bad arm. I said, no. He said, what? I said, I'm not going to be the reason you don't make the finals. Use one arm. I didn't tell him to quit. I just told him use one arm. So now he's straight to the finals.
He's only going
to
pay him for half.
That's it. Half a day's work, half an arm.
Joe, let's take a look at you in action. Let's start off with tonight, a great ride. Tonight, you and Donnie can talk about it. Let's take a look right there.
Oh, it was a good bull. Jumped out and turned back to left. You can't ask for something better than that, especially for a practice bull.
There's no lack of confidence, and I tell you, that's important. That is very, extremely important. But he's a big, strong guy. But what I like is he's got the strength to get out of a lot of jams. But watch just run me either one of his rides back on there, guys. Just watch the rhythm. Watch the timing. Watch the finesse. And that's the word I want to use, the finesse of getting going. I guarantee you, how easy was that after about the second turn and you got the windshield wiper going?
Extremely easy, and that's what Dad always said. Me being as big and strong as I am, a lot of times I'd always want to lean back and hunker down, but he said you got to ride like a little wimpy guy.
Did he mention anything?
He was looking right square at me when he does that.
Dan, he wasn't looking at you, was he?
I wasn't. That wasn't a cut at you, but that was.
ow.
You want to stand up with him again?
Not after he said that, heck no.
Let's take a look at the first round that you won here on Thursday night. Here we go, Don.
Now, that's still...
Let's rack up the one from Thursday night. He won his first outing as well here.
First NFR, first go-round, first bull. How fun is this?
That one was pretty darn fun. That ain't a practice bull.
He's scratching, clawing. He's trying to get him back off his bull rope. He spurs, but he doesn't spur wildly. He's doing this. He's under control, but he's not thinking about it. This is pure reaction. This is what you train to do. You're in there. You're in the moment. You're rock and rolling, free hand moving. And this bull fading from the front of the chutes out to the middle of the arena, was that whenever you got on the horse to go around the arena waving your hat? You know, what was were you thinking anything or just what?
It felt pretty cool. I mean, that's what everyone dreams about doing is riding bulls here. Every calf I've rode in the backyard, I mean, I've rode millions of bulls in the Thomas and Mack Center up here. And it felt pretty good to do it in person.
Joe and I have said it a jillion times, you know, you train from the neck down and you win from the neck up, and you got it going on. You was raised right. You've got a rodeo lineage history in your background, you know, and I'm jealous, not because I'm not as tall as you, but because my first NFR, first bull, first performance, Jim Shoulders walked by me and said, get up where they can shut the gate.
Did you win rounds?
That's a true story, heck no. I didn't ride a half a damn jump.
You know, you're kind of lucky we let you be on this stage tonight, because Marty's first NFR, he won the round. He won the round. I won the round. Dan won the round first time he came, so you're lucky tonight.
But I knew I could get away with it because I'm not sure that they had moving pictures back then, so nobody
no
could
proof,
find the
Kenny,
record.
No proof.
No proof.
I've been pretty lucky to have the parents and the support team I got from home and in Goodwell, Oklahoma, and as being as lucky as I've been to be around guys like Denny Flynn and Robert Etbauer and Craig Latham and Joe Beaver and Donnie Gay, and I mean, I'm extremely lucky as far as that goes.
You're extremely talented as well.
Yeah, right.
Yes.
Very, very talented.
And you better keep winning, you know, because when you agreed to come to the show and I said, just, you know, bring your family and, you know, come on out there. If you have to buy tickets for everybody to the rodeo that you brought to the show tonight, you better keep winning, buddy. They're going up on the prize.
I come up to the hotel room today after my massage, and my traveling partner and my brother are sitting in the room. They'd ordered room service and put it on the tab, and they were giving it to him, and I was telling them they needed to pay for it, and they said, you've won like $30,000. Just give it to us.
Josh, he just doesn't quit,
come
does
on,
he?
Dude.
He just doesn't stop, does he? You know, that's how he is.
I told him, I said, you guys got to pay your own way and earn it. You'll appreciate it more. You can't
introduce,
just live off
introduce
me.
Your family over here,
this
Joe.
Is Josh, Josh here. Frost, my little brother. He's 19 years old.
Little calf roping bull riding fool, too.
And my mom, Lisa Frost, is sitting next to him. And my dad, Shane Frost, is right there. And Claire Muir. He's my athletic tape sponsor. He sends me a box of tape about every month.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, it's fixing to start costing him a little more.
All these young
let me run that deal
up
for you.
And for everybody that's asking, yes, Lane Frost is your cousin through the family. The relation is there. You're living in Utah?
Yeah.
What part of Utah are you?
Near Vernal, Utah. Yeah. Randallette, little bit.
That's where I met Lane Frost, and Lane was 10 years old, was at the rodeo in Vernal, Utah.
Very cool. We're honored to have you here, Joe, and I love watching you ride. Continued success. Thank you for making time
thank
for
you
us.
For having
thank
me.
You for coming.
Thank you.
We hope to have you back on again this week. We're going to count all your earnings, and we can order some more room service.
Josh, keep charging to him. He'll be all right.
Book's too hard.
He's got to learn his signature, and then it's easy. Just copy it.
That wasn't no put on. I mean, you know, she talk about confident.
Oh, man, I love it.
I'm going to tell you what, though, and they've said it about little Marty, and they've said it about Cody, and they said it about everybody that comes along. They said it about Trey Benton. If you don't have confidence in yourself and what you can do, you're not going to get any help from anybody else. You better know you can do it.
Yep.
It's like going in there and hitting the biggest guy. Sometimes that biggest guy in the bar, if you got more confidence, you got a chance. But if you got Donnie with you, you're usually in a bind. But if you got any help, you can. If you got confidence, you're all right. But if you ain't got, if you look at your help and think, oh man, you're in a bad way.
I'm going to bring out three people here to help us wrap up this show this evening. It's a tough room, isn't it, Donnie?
Oh, I'm telling you.
Holy cow. First of all, we're going to bring out Bob and Boyd, Bob Tallman, Boyd Polhamus, but they've got a beautiful young lady with them. Her name is Lydia Hurst. We're going to talk to her as well, but let's bring them all out here together. Welcome them to national finals tonight. Come on out, gang. Hi. Come on out.
Come on, Dad.
Have
a seat.
All right.
Come on, Bob. Sit down.
No, you sit next to her. You're prettier.
Hello, handsome. Have a seat here.
Hi, buddy.
Lydia, we're glad to have you with us here tonight.
I am so happy to be here tonight.
You're in pretty rough company, as you can tell, but by golly, we'll see if they can keep their manners in order. And Lydia is here, Bob, because the bowling, the charity, and all that took place today that Bob is a big part of. Lydia, who is supermodel of the year, graced the covers of Glamour and Vogue magazine all over the world. And for me, in my age group, Patty Hurst is Lydia's mother. Her great-grandfather is William Randolph Hurst. So some pretty darn impressive lineage there as well. So, but she was good enough to come.
I felt like I knew your family.
She was good enough to come here and to bowl, hopefully not with Donnie, but to bowl. And so, Bob.
Do you know, for the last 30 minutes, it's been very difficult with her in the dressing room, sitting there trying to watch you on the monitor, because if we had a choice of watching.
Well, he was on the monitor?
That's what, yeah.
But you guys wouldn't even, like, come sit next to me.
Well,
you don't know what a blessing that was.
See, we're not as good as we once were. But we're as good once as we ever were.
And as nice as that young bodyguard stallion you got sitting back there on the couch with you, you know, why would you put a turd in a punch bowl when you got champagne sitting there in the way?
That's my boyfriend you're talking about.
And I know your grandpa, and he'd go for that. He went, yep, that's just the way it is.
Lydia, tell us about you. Oh, please tell us something. Tell us about your. Tell us about your first try. I want to tell you, Donnie has a belt just like that. Tell us about. A
few more notches.
Yeah. He wears it around his thigh. Tell us about your first trip here to Las Vegas and being around this bunch. We're honored to have you here.
Well, you know, this is actually my first time coming here for the NFR and being in the bowling tournament. I'm sorry to say that I am a terrible bowler, but I was over
doesn't
the moon.
Matter.
Doesn't so matter when you look
here.
Like you do. Nobody
knew. Nobody saw the ball go toward
no,
a pin.
No.
So what happened to my score?
You had the gutter ball. It didn't make any. You had the gutter rails up. It didn't make no difference.
What was funny?
No, they didn't let me. They didn't give me the rails this year.
They didn't?
No.
It was funny.
So I threw it in the gutter myself.
You know what? Charlie Too Tall West. Yeah. Charlie Too Tall West was next to him, and somebody went, "Look, there's two midgets out there playing today."
Charlie Too Tall, who is a certified midget, we've done the genetics, and
Were you the one trying to toss him?
No, that was
Oatberry.
That was Oatberry. Okay. He was going to throw him down. But anyway, it was like, who's that guy Donnie's looking up to? And it was Charlie Too Tall. But.
Dan,
he did a great job.
Dan,
tonight,
you lost it, Dan. It's gone. You can't even get it back, Dan.
what it was the bowling tournament that brought you to us?
Well, actually,
we're gonna have another one.
It starts at midnight on the 10th floor.
Actually, it was actually Gary Lafew who brought me here to
Vegas.
I don't know how many stories he's told you guys, but
oh, yeah.
I'm a huge fan of the rodeos, especially the bull riders and the bulls. And I, through a few friends of mine, got in contact with Gary Lafew, and a few months back, he started teaching me how to bull ride. And I'm probably the only person who's ever ridden a bull naked.
I got the story, and now that you've started it.
You really fix to lose the show now. I'm telling you.
Get LaFue's number on the speed dial. I want to work the strip and shoot.
I guarantee you what, I just want to pass out towels at shower time. I'll be there the next time you get on one.
Elizabeth, I'm coming home.
Elizabeth, this is a big one.
This is it.
Hey, well, here's a big deal out of the deal. What Liddy did today, Charlie Too Tall West, all the celebrities that were there, helped us raise over $40,000 for the Justin Cowboy Crisis Fund and the Raceways and Jackie Ferrando and Boyd Gaming that made this thing happen. And I'm sure glad you were dressed bowling.
Yes, I'm not. Was.
It's going to take $20,000 to get the smile off the bull. Let's, we've...
Are you sure you want to rethink that?
Is that on your script?
There,
that's upside down.
Yeah, that's it. That's
you know what that looked like on a bowl upside down?
Boy.
What Jim Shoulder said about making a saddle for that pretty lady to ride.
No.
I ain't going there.
No. Lydia, I know that you've got some, let's plug some of the movies. You have some films coming out in 2015, I think, that are either in production or you've just finished. Tell us what to look for.
Well, I just finished filming a couple different movies, some romantic comedies, some horror thrillers, and I'm actually in the middle of production on a new television show. I don't know if y'all are familiar with the guy who created Dexter, but he created the show that I'm on now, and it's also executive produced by Eli Roth, and it's called South of Hell.
And when will those be, when can we see those and where can we see those?
Everything's going to be coming out in spring, summer of 2015. And the movies are going to be distributed in theaters nationwide, and the television show, I believe, airs in April on the WE TV network.
Very cool. So you had this desire to ride a bull.
I did,
and so
yeah.
You got a hold of Gary.
I did. Well, of all the people
and
that
why
I know,
in Lind- why didn't you at least have on a pair of shoes or something? Why would you?
Well, see, the reason I got in touch with Gary was through Johnny Knoxville.
Okay.
There explains so, by it.
So
suddenly
of
the
all
veil
my friends,
has been lifted.
You know, I've been a huge fan of the bull riding, and out of all my friends, I thought to myself, you know, I really want to ride a bull. Who out of everyone I know would know where I can find a bull? And of course, Johnny Knoxville popped into my head. I rang him up and got in touch with Gary LaFue, and next thing you know, I'm over at Gary's house riding a bull. And then I got naked.
Did Gary at least have on a hat?
That, and,
I was gonna say,
I wasn't gonna forget it after the first time.
That's happened before.
Hey, Donnie, little Marty just throwed all his picking strings away. Straight to bull ropes.
Well, I will say, I just wanted to do something that no one in the history of bull riding had ever done, and...
Well, that's where you're sorely disappoint you, but Donnie rode naked once, too. But,
No!
But it was, you know, his last name and everything, so...
You can ask Kristen. We actually produced a rodeo one time at a nudist colony. Serious. And it's amazing what they accomplished, what you can do with chaps and a glove. And that was it. Been there, done that, bought the T-shirt and the cap. Hey, so, honey.
Wait. Here, use his. It's better.
No, it happened. I got it. It's in my mind, and it's still in my heart.
I hope to hell they didn't have Dally team roping in, did they?
Well... It was right after they invented duct tape, and it was safe.
If they did, I'll guarantee you he looked like Whiplash the Cowboy Monkey.
Narco, California, about 1975. I've seen that monkey do that before. His little bitty hands can cover a whole lot of monkey when you're hurting.
This is why it's good we're on the World Wide Web. There are no ratings.
Let me just say one thing. And your family and the beautiful property on the beach and all that they have done of being generous to share their beauty in the coastal areas of California and all that you're about to get into. You will never sit on a stage again with five more heartfelt really want you to do well. because of what you've done at rodeo, and you've come here and touched us. And we will follow you and your career, and we all wish you the best. And that's the serious side of all the BS that you've been listening to. You're beautiful, and we hope, I just hope you soar.
Well, thank you very much. And honestly, it was my honor to be here for this and to actually participate in the bowling tournament. And I mean, I hope you guys will have me back again in the future, because I think it's an incredible organization. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I love going to the rodeos, and I love watching what everybody does. And, you know, I've seen it with my own eyes that every time they go out there and ride, they're putting their lives, their careers, and everything on the line. And I think it's incredible what you guys all do.
Marty wants to drive.
Well, I would also suggest, Mr. Tolman, seeing as your name on the tournament, right?
Yes, sir.
That perhaps we start a little bit later and have a naked bowling tournament, because...
Well, it was discussed at one point this morning, and guess who brought it up? Gary LaFeu. Now, Marty...
I'm not surprised.
Marty H.'s mother sitting right beside him. And I don't... You're going to have to get a bigger camper on that bigger truck and have to clean that calf rope and rig up if you expect to have anything of this height and design joining that board going down the road.
Hey, that ain't all true, because Tolman told me one time, the better you rope and the more you win, the better your choices are.
Yeah, there are choices. There's a fork in the road. You pick one you want to go and then
yeah,
go with
and
it.
Yeah, and take the one less traveled.
Yeah, but if you ain't hot and sweaty and broke when you get there, you ain't hungry enough to win, are you, Joe? Could we start, Lenny? Let's go back outside and come back in. Let's start this thing all over.
Well, I just...
You're the boss here. Get a hold of this thing.
It's just dawned on me. We've never had anybody on National Finals tonight naked. So, Joe...
Hey, wait a minute. I walked in Bob Tolman's room one night. I needed a place to stay. And it was late, and I hadn't been asleep for 4 or 5 days probably. And I walked in the room, and he comes out of the shower. And he's, I didn't know you was coming here tonight. I said, shit, I'm leaving now. I was leaving the hallway.
And ain't no better than the night Charlie Sampson spent with me, and he had a little red Speedo on.
And they like a chocolate-covered cherry, didn't
you? Yeah. They lost his luggage. If you don't know how Charlie Sampson is, he's 5'2". He's my little black brother and a great guy and a world champion bull rider. Messed up Donnie. And about 2 in the morning, here come the bellman with his luggage that they lost. So I just kind of got out of bed, threw the covers back, let the guy in, and just the light out of the hall was coming in. All you could see was his little black foot with a white bottom sticking out. And over here was part of that Speedo off his little black butt. And Bellman walks in with the luggage and goes like, well, I'm sure glad I got his, oh my God. And he just dropped the bag. I didn't have time to tip him. He cut a trail like his butt was on fire. I reached over, Charlie says, he didn't stay long, did you give him a tip? And I said, no, he got enough tip looking at you half naked in his bed. Out the door he went.
Oh, my word. Lydia, thank you for weathering this storm. Would you give Lydia a hand here? Lydia Hurst, stay right there. Give all of these guys a hand, please. Joe Beaver, Boy Paul Hamas, stay right there. Lydia, Donnie Gay, and Bob Tolman. Let me tell you, we have lots of prizes to give away, and we're going to do that as soon as we say goodbye to the television cameras. They may not be turned on again. So stay where you're at. We'll do our goodbye here on that, and then we'll give away lots of prizes. Thank you for being with us here tonight on National Finals tonight. Thank you. Roll it, guys.
We're gonna dance and party till the cows come home at the fucking ball.